My name is Nicolas Bakirtzis. I'm associate professor at the Cyprus Institute and also director of the Andreas Pitas Art Characterization Laboratories. Our work and collaboration and our relations with Italian research and education is quite serious. I would describe that it's both at the level of close collaborations, whether it's with research and university institutions like the University of Padua, but also the Accademia dei Lincei, in the field of restoration, the Opificio delle Pietre Dure, and also we also have collaborations with archaeological missions here in Cyprus. But I would also describe that we have the actual contribution by the physical presence of several of our colleagues at the Andreas Pitas laboratories, where we have four Italian colleagues working with us closely day to day, contributing their knowledge in archaeology and cultural heritage. But also what is important is that being in Cyprus, our focus on the influence of Italian art, particularly during the medieval and the early modern period in Cyprus and the broader region, as well as the relationship between Cyprus and Italy, whether at the level of the exchange of art, artistic objects, the trade, the remnants of Italian travelers and also Venice in Cyprus are of great importance. I would say that among the highlights of aspects of our work, we've worked on works and paintings by great Italian masters like Titian. We've been also studying El Greco's period in Venice, as well as paintings from the circle of Giotto, and in particular Giovanni Baronzio. These are only some highlights of the works we have analyzed at APAC Labs, where we've been using the advances in technology, digital technology, and scientific analysis to study aspects of the materiality, the technique, as well as the provenance and the authenticity of works of art and archaeological material. One of the distinct characteristics of our Italian colleagues here, and one I've always talked about, how I feel that Italian researchers coming to Cyprus, they are here to truly contribute and they devote themselves. They love the island. I'm always amazed by how familiar they are with Cyprus, how much they like being here, and in general, their presence as part of our group in our institute and in Cyprus in general is tremendously important and at the same time generous with their time, with they truly share their knowledge, their expertise. They also learn Greek. And I would say that I think that this highlights this historical and long relationship between Cyprus and Italy. And these young researchers truly are ambassadors of this reality and this close relationship. A special reference should be made also with the collaboration that we have with the Carabinieri on aspects of the illicit trafficking of cultural heritage goods, where they are offering us and they're advising us and collaborating with us on a range of important activities and also international and European initiatives.
Hello, my name is Sorin Hermon. I'm associate professor at the Cyprus Institute. I have spent 8 years in Italy at the University of Florence as a researcher. And in 2008, together with Professor Franco Nicolucci, we established the first version of the laboratories of STAR-C, the Science and Technology in Archaeological and Cultural Heritage Research at the Cyprus Institute. Since then, we have amplified and extended our collaborations with several research and academic and educational institutions in Cyprus, and also institutions that work in Cyprus in archaeological research, such as CNR of Rome, working with Maria Rosaria Belgiorno, with Oliva Menozzi from the University of Chieti, with Massimo Perna from the University of Sassari. With each one of them, we have several projects that deal particularly with the implementation of digital tools and methods into the archaeological research. Within this framework, we are hosting also several Erasmus students from Italy, from various universities. But we also have enrolled here a number of Italian students who are working at cutting-edge research, also thanks to the very good preparation they are coming from the Italian universities. In particular, with Massimo Perna, who is an expert on ancient languages and writings, and under my supervision as a PhD supervisor at the Cyprus Institute, we are working on a very challenging subject, on setting up the first steps towards deciphering an understood until now writing from Cyprus, the Cyprominoan, where Martina Polig, an Italian citizen student, is applying novel methods regarding 3D documentation, scientific visualization and analysis to characterize these symbols.
I'm Dante Abate. I'm an associate research scientist at the Cyprus Institute. My background is in archaeology, but since the last 10 years I've been working on the application of digital technologies for the protection of cultural heritage. Currently, I am a project leader of several initiatives involving both the Cypriot institution and the Italian partners. The main topic is the fight against illicit trafficking of cultural properties, both with the use of aerial platforms such as drones and the application of a novel artificial intelligence algorithm. In particular, we have been working with the Università Politecnica delle Marche, who is an institution specialized in the customization of artificial intelligence algorithm, as well with the Bruno Kessler Foundation in Trento, which is also a leader in the application of digital technologies in the protection of cultural heritage. My expertise is the use of 3D modeling digital technologies for the protection and the valorization of cultural heritage. Specifically, I am specialized in the use of 3D scanning and photogrammetry, both for the documentation of site as well as for the creation of virtual reality environment. This range from objects that are currently placed in museum, but also focused on the documentation of archaeological site or monuments.
My name is Valentina Vassallo and I've been working at the Cyprus Institute since 2009 as a research assistant. My PhD research is on the study of terracotta figurines from Aierini, an important site in Cyprus. The site of Aierini was excavated by an expedition from Sweden in 1927 and is considered the most important site for the chronology of Cyprus. My study focuses on terracotta figurines from the site, and actually I'm revising the material that was studied many years ago. And I'm doing this thing through digital technologies because I'm developing a 3D methodology, an integrated methodology based on geometric and non-invasive chemical analysis to understand, to interpret these small terracotta figurines, to understand the production and the deposition of these artifacts. My work consists of studying the small figurines from the sanctuary, and I'm doing with the employment of technologies, and especially of digital technologies. I'm studying the possible new classification, new ways of classifications of the material, analyzing by geometric investigation and non-invasive physicochemical analysis. The geometric investigation consists of 3D digitally acquiring the artifacts, so reproducing, documenting them, and then reproducing it in 3D. And in this way, it's possible to compare the shapes of the artifacts, and to understand if there are specific patterns that can bring us to similarities. And highlighting these similarities, we can after try a new way of classification of this material. Specifically for the site, this kind of work is important to understand also the production of the material. So to understand the type of workshop involved in this kind of production, if there are one or more hands producing them. So this is very important to understand not only people of the past using this material, but also investigating who produced them. In the identification of the production, an important element is also, for example, the study of the fingerprints, because, for example, they can help us to understand if, for example, an object is done by the same person, if it's done from a young artisan or an older artisan. The geometrical and shape analysis of these small figurines was done also in collaboration with an Italian team, and specifically in collaboration with the Institute for Applied Mathematics and Information Technologies of the National Research Council of Italy, that helped in this specific work.
My name is Brunella Santarelli. I am a research technical specialist in STAR-C. I work with the Archaeological Material Science Labs, where I am responsible for all the technical operations and support of the labs, which serve STAR-C but also the wider CYI community. I am a material scientist, and I come from a background of archaeology and chemistry. What my job here in STAR-C is I provide technical support for the Archaeological Material Science Labs, and I collaborate on projects with internal researchers as well as external. And what that entails is we get materials almost exclusively inorganic, so things like ceramics, glasses, metals, and slags, and we take them here and we do processing and analysis, and we analyze things such as mineralogy, composition, to be able to reconstruct technological processes. For example, one of the projects that we are working on now is with metallurgical remains from Hala Sultanteke, which is a late Bronze Age site in Cyprus. And we are focusing specifically on metallurgical remains, such as metals and slags, but also we've done some work on crucibles and tuyeres. And what we are interested in is to analyze these materials to try to reconstruct the technological processes and to get a better idea of what was happening during the smelting process. Working in Cyprus is great. Here at CYI, we have a wonderful community of researchers that we collaborate with, and we also have a really wonderful set of laboratories with very modern equipment, which allows us to do all sorts of different analytical work.
I'm Mia Trentin. I'm at the Cyprus Institute from 2017, when I started with a postdoc position, joined with the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign with a specific project on medieval and early modern graffiti. I have a background in history and archaeology for the medieval period, and I'm focusing on written sources, specifically on graffiti. After my first postdoc, my Marius Ludowska Curie proposal was founded by the Research and Innovation Foundation of Cyprus. So I've started to study Cypriot medieval and early modern graffiti. Now I'm working here, structuring a methodology for their study and analysis, for their documentation and for their interpretation. I'm also following an European project as a Cyprus partner, that is the Coast Action Underground for Built Heritage. The project coordinator is based in Italy, the CNR in Naples, the Institute for Maritime Studies, and we are all across Europe and also abroad studying this peculiar kind of heritage, trying to valorize it in relationship with the local communities. With my research on graffiti, I'm not only studying the Cypriot graffiti, but also I'm studying other sites in Italy, like the Church of San Marco in Venice, that was the focus of my first postdoc at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. And I'm very happy and glad to collaborate with the local institution because they are very willing to know all this written heritage and all these messages from the past coming up to light again. And another project that hopefully we will start soon is in Siena at the Duomo. Unfortunately, due to the pandemic, we had to stop the preparation, but we hope that soon the situation will allow us to go and to start a collaboration also with the Opera del Duomo, the local Soprintendenza, and the University of Siena. Working in Cyprus, I found it really nice. Okay, from my point of view, there's a richness of material, and not only for graffiti in general, Cyprus has a really deep and long-lasting history. An Italian should be studying Cyprus. We can start from the historical tradition, because there's an historical tradition of Italian studying Cyprus. And then we can mention also the fact that Cyprus had an Italian Venetian period, so there's also this specific political contact that is much more extended, because Cyprus was always the point between East and West, so all the mariners coming from Italy, travelers and so on, heading to the East, were passing by. From a more personal point of view, I found Cyprus fascinating because it's an island, so it's very intriguing. I have been living in Venice, another island, so I can feel this dimension of insularities here too, of course in a bigger scale.